In terms of state-of-the-art technology, today we are actually addressing, as Mr. Belokas said before, three types of domains: the research via autonomous vessel, the technology via the Internet of Things and fog computing, and the shipping software via what's called cloud computing. In terms of autonomous vessel, what is the effort? The effort is to actually eliminate the human factor, the human factor error. And this effort requires from us to actually see vessels that they will be in the future mainly unmanned. As we speak, as Mr. Belokas mentioned before, there are at least four company conglomerates around the globe as we speak to actually, you know, demonstrate that particular type of concept. In terms of technology and the Internet of Things and fog computing, sensors, they are collecting information, they are gathering information around the vessels, and they're seeing this kind of information on shore. And in terms of cloud computing, the idea is basically that software is transferred to the cloud and it's offered nowadays to companies either as a software as a service, business as a service, or even as a platform as a service. So basically, if we want to state what would be the challenge that we all face for tomorrow's ship management, is how to actually manage the ship, the smart ship. What kind of technology we should actually apply and what kind of software we should actually apply in order to eliminate any kind of possible error. Ships are collecting day in and day more and more information, mainly from sensors, from machinery and bridge control equipment, that they actually are transferred through other kinds of vessels, and all of them they are seeking back to databases on shore. The internet becomes more and more available, where amazing volumes of information are getting transferred, and this kind of information in a form of structure or unstructured is creating a lot of hassle in terms of interpreting and associating. So what will be the challenge? The challenge is to actually create corporate systems that can actually harness the information, associate the information, and create value out of it. Value that comes in terms of gauges, graphs, or even geolocated type of points. Why? Because the key is to actually have situational awareness, the so-called nowcasting, to know what's going on holistically, 360 degrees around. And in order to do that, we are actually using what-if scenarios for forecasting, and we are actually leveraging on past information, which is called postcasting. In other words, action needs to be taken based on this particular type of scenarios for three types of stakeholders. It's either the crew on board, the office associates, or the partners. 360 situation awareness and forecasting requires actions in three types of domains: effectiveness, statutory compliance, and risk. And this is an endless process of workflow scenarios that they actually require correct management, either automated or manually. Those are workflows executed by the stakeholders, which are users of the same system. And how does DANAOS addresses all this kind of the challenges? Mainly with three systems: WAVES, the recently awarded Deloitte's Big Data as a business intelligence system; the rule compliance system, which is a regulatory compliance and workflow system; and the DANAOS One collaboration platform. Discussing about how we actually work on WAVES, I will have to say that the most important thing is create a cleansing data, creating a data warehouse where information is homogeneous and the data integrity is very, very much important. In this kind of situation, we analyze this kind of formation, we associate the data, and we create searchable types of domains within these types of business, giving the user correct insights. Consequently, KPIs, key performance indexes, in terms of situation awareness, can detect anomalies. And we can evaluate the plan to prevent and react accordingly. Of course, all this kind of information can be used in the future for all kinds of forecasting what-if scenarios. So WAVES fleet performance system, it's about recording and optimizing the fleet utilization and proposing the best speed and route for better financial and environmental results. It's also about recording the vessel fuel consumption and verify the charter party compliance and evaluate hull, engine, and propeller efficiency. It's an offer to the ultimate fleet management dashboard with ongoing voyage analysis, visualization of performance data, alerts of non-control risk, like the bad weather, prior piracy zone, stoppages, etc. Alarms are analyzed, they can identify the cause, and accordingly we can propose mitigated type of actions. And we trigger, of course, condition-based maintenance. I took the initiative to actually extract out of weight some indicative dashboards. They are personalized. That means the information they contain, they are for different types of user roles of the system. So the first one here, we can see how we can actually record the vessel fuel consumption. We can verify the charter party compliance and evaluate the hull, the engine. We can see actually the charter party how do we produce forecast and how we are actually creating benchmarks for the market. The third template shows how we can produce key performance indicators from technical condition, and how do we actually support the specialized analysis in terms of trim optimization, lubricants consumption, and so on. What is really also important is the fact of the compliance, the statutory compliance itself. So all types of records on vessels, they become electronic logs. So they are electronic forms that they actually capture the information on source, and this information can also be input by the users themselves. So regulatory compliance systems enables the shipping companies to actually capture the information, to see the alerts, and create the necessary mitigation plan on terms of the forms. The system proposes what kind of plan we should actually take in control based on a predefined process. And last but not least, it has to do with collaboration and information diffusal, dissemination of information among trusted partners. And this is DANAOS One. DANAOS One is a collaboration platform that disseminates information safely among trusted partners, where they can have access via their mobile or a web. Here I have a short video that I will show you. We create mobile applications that they are based on the data that's stored inside the typical ship management systems. And those applications are available for online and offline sync. DANAOS at a glance is a company that has more than 30 years of history. We have more than 500 clients worldwide and more than 5,000 DANAOS software installations on vessels. We are actually trying to foresee the future and to actually innovate all the time, bringing in new software and new systems. We have recently been awarded the Lloyd's Big Data Awards for Waves, and we have been Edelman finalists in the past. That's some of the awards we have been actually granted. I hope that I actually passed to you the way that DANAOS addresses the challenges for the ship management system, and tell you that all three systems are fully integrated and they're interoperable. Thank you.